to attend our event this night, this evening. We have gathered today in order to summarize opportunities associated with the creation of the European technology platform in the area of high performance computing. Technology platforms are industry-led organizations whose aim is to define what should be researched and developed in order to strengthen the European industry and economy. The members of today's panel represents Prospect, which is the promotion of supercomputing partnerships for European competitiveness and technology. We are an association of industry and research organizations, and our goal is to promote science and research in the area of HPC. We also welcome to our panel Dr. Bernard Fabianek from the European Commission, who kindly asked to join us today. We all believe that there is a need to provide support to the European HPC industry by the creation of an European technology platform. Such organization can help Europe define its research priorities in HPC. We have prepared a vision document that proves the needs for the platform, and we have consensus on the vast majority of our members to initiate this process. Today, we are here to share our views on these topics. And for this, we have prepared this panel. And the first panelist is Professor Thomas Lippert, presenting the idea for an ETP in the high performance computing. Please, Thomas.
Thanks, Sergi. So I'm very happy that we are here this evening and that you are attending this session. I would very shortly like to introduce you to the what and why and how of a technology platform. And I'm also thankful that the previous speaker just before has very much emphasized that an ETP, we call it, a European technology platform, would be a very important instrument to reach the goal that European HPC can grow and can be fostered. So let's start with what. What is a European technology platform? It's a body supported by industry and academia and research. The ETP is created to align research priorities in industrial areas. It is those areas that are critical to the growth of the economy in the European Union. And the ETP invites all stakeholders that think that their research and their activities are relevant for this to join. So this ETP is, that we have in mind is open. So why do we need an ETP? HPC certainly has strategic importance worldwide for science and industry. We have heard before exascale seems to be under borders. Of course, it's not yet. It will take some time. But that's a very big motivation, and we know all what it means to work with millions of cores and what very important work has to be done to reach this. And especially this holds for the industry. EU certainly has an outstanding competence in the application of HPC. We know all that many of the leading methods, algorithms, industrially relevant methods and algorithms as well, have been created in Europe and are applied in Europe. We believe that HPC is a cradle for innovation and for excellence, and therefore we have to stimulate the growth of the whole HPC supply chain. We need to repopulate the HPC job market also in the creation of technology in the EU. And we have to do this by helping to guide the EC research priorities. This is the reason why we need a European technology platform. Now, coming to my last slide, how is this done? I don't give details here, I only show the three stages of this process. Stage one, the stakeholders come together and formulate a vision document. That's exactly what we will hear next and what we have formulated. So we are at stage one. Stage two, the stakeholders define strategic research agendas that are medium to long term. Additionally, of course, they define their governance and how they want to govern this process. In stage three, the strategic research agenda is implemented, and the projects that have to be defined for that strive for EU and funding, public funding, together with industrial funding. Okay, let's see how. And now I'm at my end, so I give back to Sergio.
Thank you very much, Thomas. Now I introduce Bernard Fabiani from the European Commission to present the Europe's strategy on HPC.
Thank you very much. Well, we have heard the presentation from Bo. I'm still moved by it. It was fantastic to listen to it. But in 2009, actually, the European Commission presented a strategy about the importance of e-infrastructures, the new way science is carried out. So the new paradigm on how we conduct not only science, but address challenges we were facing nowadays. And there was a person as medicine studying the human brain, the keynote really. And there we sort of set out and think we have a world-class communication infrastructure, as you know. We have developed distributed computing concepts with the Greeks, widely adopted. Everybody talks about clouds, a simplified version of that. And this afternoon's fourth session, we have talked about the address of data, and now we are sitting here on a big panel discussing HPC and what we can do in Europe to strengthen it. In 2009, then the member states responded to this commission document by saying, yes, please go ahead and develop a strategy for high-performance computing in Europe. The European Commission Services are working on that, and we are looking forward to present that strategy at the end of this year. And actually, it will contain several pillars and important messages, and fully in line with what we have heard from Matthew Fox on this, we need to strengthen the supply and the use of HPC in Europe. And again, if you have been in the session on praise this afternoon, it's just not acceptable that the praise is oversubscribed by a factor of 6 in terms of CPU hours requested. You see what huge demand we have in Europe, and we just can't fulfill it because we're lacking the number of systems and we're lacking also the capacity of them. This also has been highlighted by a recent IDC report that was also just quoted in the previous presentation. What we also need to overcome is the fragmentation. We have plenty of systems, single racks standing over in many places, and people are buying them for their individual needs, but if we could pull this, and that's a recommendation of the member state ministers that said we have to pull our efforts to strengthen them and to be more effective. So this governance that we have shown now is praised in the academic sector is really working fine, and we have to extend that and really build on this. Again, in line with the previous presentation, we have seen that we need much more trained, a larger trained workforce, because even if we have the systems, we need to sort of bring it to good use, need to entice industry, not only to supply them, but also to use them. It's key for Europe's competitiveness, and we've seen that the whole day in these presentations. At the very end, what we make out of it. And then still, Europe is a player on the global scale. Yes, we want to sell HPC systems, of course, we want to use them, but what's most important, we have global challenges. Climate change, fight against cancer, whatever it is. And there we need to work together and to provide Europe as an ecosystem where people want to come and do research in, because the environment is the right one. It has the communication, it has the data, and it has the computing facilities. So that's why a technology platform, high-performance computing, is really key to underline and strengthen the strategy that we will present at the end of the year. So I'm very happy to be here to see what the European industry has to offer and how it can sort of will do this together.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Bernard. So our next panelist is Dr. Maria Ramalho, Prospect Association representing, and I want her to introduce the vision principles on HPC in Europe for 2020.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I thank you for your interest to be here in this room when everybody's not party after the full day of presentations at this wonderful IC event. I'm speaking on behalf of these people that are sitting here and many others that have worked now for a full year to concretize a vision for what we deem important to highlight in Europe in terms of HPC investments in research and development. So I thank all of them for giving me this opportunity to talk to you. Bit of context. We started with this idea of creating really something special, a four-leaf clover for HPC in Europe. And the four-leaf clover has four contextual settings. One is that we have started a structural process in terms of HPC investments in Europe with the launch of the research infrastructure phase. Then we have tackled this idea that, oh, we need to keep up in the front, so we need to tackle even more, we need to tackle the existing challenge. So we've been working on to structure also our research and development to pair up with other continents to tackle this challenge. Then we need to assert that we're also ending, in terms of investments in research, an end of a current framework program, and it's now time to think over what would be the necessity for further investments in the next framework program. And of course, we are in a very unstable period in Europe that was initiated with the financial crisis, and we're still struggling. So where is HPC then? What can we do? Okay, in terms of investments, we definitely need to join HPC competence from private and public sectors. This is a way to tackle the exascale challenge, because there's a lot of know-how in both sectors that we need to concretize. In terms of investments, we need to definitely increase the RTD envelope for HPC R&D in Europe. And for tackling other economic settings, we also need to increase the industrial take-up of HPC for the sake of maintaining or enlarging its competitiveness. Okay, so the idea came. We are not going to talk to you about a cloud. This is about cloud, it's about a crowd. We are a crowd. We are a group of people that think together, that are trying to assert what would be the ideal investments for HPC in Europe, what would be the strategic research agenda. And there we are. We created this idea, let's start a European technology platform on high-performance computing, right? Now, the rest is what came out of it. What is the vision? Five principles have been defined. The first one being, we want Europe to be a leader in terms of inventions that successfully exploit HPC resources. So we want to create innovation. We want to use HPC to really promote new ideas, new products, to help visualize these ideas as well, to make these things more concrete. Then we think about a social perspective. What HPC can bring to this perspective in terms of all sorts of societal issues that also need access to very powerful computing machines for decision making. And there we want to introduce the idea of creating software tools and services that help to make more accurate and responsive predictions on societal challenges. The third one is in terms of promoting energy efficiency in the products that we develop in Europe, in using HPC as a tool to help to create this products and these solutions. The fourth is to really make a branding for the HPC technologies designed in Europe. We want these technologies to be the most energy efficient compared with technologies designed elsewhere. And the fifth is really an assertion of principles. Is really an assertion of the technology components and systems where Europe excels, and to, when these are defined, to really work towards making them really competitive. And with this, I finish my talk. I thank you for your attention. If there are more questions, please don't hesitate to talk to me in the rest of the day or elsewhere if you need. Many thanks for your attention.
Thank you very much, Maria. Now it's the turn of Gianpietro Tecchioli from Eurotech to present us the industrial perspective for an ETP on HPC. Gianpietro.
Thank you. So first of all, let me add also my thanks to everybody for your interest in this important strategic discussion. But it's not only players in this arena, but also as European citizens. So let me try to give you in 5 minutes which is the standpoint of the industry, European industry in the high performance computing roadmap that these initiatives want to implement and so on. So, first of all, we know, everybody knows that HPC has generated a lot of benefits in the European environment in the last years by facilitating a number of achievements, and in the slide you can see a list of them that are listed in the vision document. In fact, in the slide is an excerpt of the vision document. What is really important for the industrial environment in Europe is the statement that is also reported in the vision document that the HPC technology can boost the competitive advantage of many European industries. So the benefits that can be generated by strategic HPC development roadmap are important not only for the direct effects that they can have on the specific high performance computers or supercomputers and so on, but also in the indirect benefits that the technologies that are developed to build supercomputers can be reused in other markets and to design other products. What is important is that to achieve this strategy, important that a suitable marketing strategy listed in the vision document and operations strategies are really implemented. And this is one of the tasks. The first task, the most important task of this ETP initiative as soon as it is established. Why this is important? Because in some way we know that in the HPC business model there are different approaches. So we have the seller approach. The seller's approach is an approach in which generated value is more or less 15% of the revenues. So there is no IP, IP is the intellectual property generated. There is no reuse, for sure. Intellectual property. We have also a slightly better approach, the integrator business model, in which the generated value is slightly higher, from 15 to 25%. There is some IP, intellectual property, that can be generated because integration needs some developments. But this intellectual property is very hard to be reused because very often it is specific to integration-related aspects. The situation is different for manufacturers. In fact, for manufacturers, the generated value is higher, we are in the range of 40 to 70% of revenues, the contribution to intellectual property is important, and also the reuse of these intellectual properties is important. And not only, as I said, in a specific domain, but also in indirect applications and so on. And this is what, in some way, the ETP can boost at European level, because to achieve that it's important to work together, to work in a cooperative and collaborative environment. This is what the ETB is advising. Finally, just to confirm that, let's say that high-performance computing is a source for innovation for the industrial players, because by developing supercomputers or technologies that can be used to build supercomputers, it is possible to generate technology innovation, for sure. It is possible to generate product and service innovation, because thanks to the reuse of the technological components, it is possible even to produce innovation in the processes, because managing supercomputers are complex. Deploying, maintaining, it requires also process innovation. And finally, high-performance computing is a source of innovation for business model innovation, because thanks to super the level of complexity, also the size and the characteristic of the supercomputing solutions, very often, as I have to say, we can see in the last recent news, the cloud computing model, we are really changing, we can really change the way we do businesses. We implement new businesses in Europe by using a service like approach to the product. This is it from my
thank you very much, Peter. Now I give the word to Professor Arnbodel as a Grace representative on explaining now how Grace is supporting the ATB for HPC.
Thank you very much. As a member of the Grace Council for the hosting partner Germany, but also as a member of the Prospect Board, I would like to explain why Grace supports the idea of bringing up an ETP for HPC. First of all, what is Grace? In one sentence, Grace is a partnership of 21 European nations that brings up an infrastructure with an important mission. What is Grace doing? It is all defined in the mission paper of Grace. And this is shown here in the three main pillars of the Grace mission. First of all, Grace has to deliver HPC services for European science. This is certainly currently the most important action Grace is doing. It, as was said by Mr. Fabianek, this service of Grace is massively overbooked. Secondly, Grace also has to deliver HPC services for the industry in Europe, for the application of European industry. And in order to do so, Grace must evaluate architectures, system software, and application codes in order to always make the best offering available to science and industrial applications. And for this purpose, Grace has created Stratos as an interface between the users of HPC in Grace and the suppliers of technology. And out of Stratos, there was the development of Prospect Association, an association to support technology development for this purpose. So, and it is nothing but more natural that Grace now supports the development of specific European competence in this field. And the main aim is to bring together all the players in order to keep Europe competitive in all fields of industry, science, and applications.
Thank you very much, Professor Boden. Now I think it's time for the handover of the vision paper from the Prospect Association to the European Commission. So, Maria.
So, again, it's my privilege to pass this. It will be more pretty but now it's still quite pretty because it has everything in it that we've been working on in 1 year. So it's my pleasure to offer now to the Commission the proof of our work in terms of the revision document and also of the letters of intent that we've been able to collect. There are about 22 here. There will be 4 or 5 more still to be added to this pack. And yes, let's hope that this will be just the start of something even more important to use.
And we have organized a remaining part of the session with a set of questions to the panelists. So we have prepared those questions. So the first questions will be addressed to Dr. Arnaud Girard from Cast Vision. And my question to you is, what do you expect from the ATP on HPC as an European SME, as an inventor?
Okay, Cast Vision as a leading integrator here in Europe for cluster management and turnkey clusters. We saw in the past that in Europe the R&D is sponsorship or is very fragmented, and especially for HPC we need a push to the market. And we saw also that these sponsorships or these developments was only done by big companies. And we see now with the European platform, with this new defined technology platform, a chance that 3 points are solved. We want to be part of this technology network, that we know the customer needs, that we know the trends, that we are really in front of the technology edge. And we want to be able to make new partnerships. In most of our projects, we are partnering with a lot of companies. However, we partner on products, and now we have the chance to partner in R&D projects, which is a totally different way. And that might be provided by this platform. And last but not least, we want to be enabled to develop a cluster management to the needs of exascale, which means that probably you have to manage 100,000 nodes or whatever, and this should be done as one system. So that's a huge challenge, and we need the right partners, the right technology, the right customers, and your new group, European platform might be the right thing to do.
Thank you very much, Arnaud. My next question is to Thomas Hartlis from T-Systems, and the question is, how could joint research process help your company to compete at global level?
Yeah. Thanks, Hajim, for the question. It's quite interesting for an IT service provider to get this question. As you know, it's all about growth for IT service provider. Knowledge is one of our base parts. Yeah, research projects will, of course, enable not only us, but most of all our customers to use in the near future PETA and EXA flop systems. And I think this is essential. We have done some national research funded projects in the past years before, and we run quite good with it and we see a big benefit of it. But from our point of view, it is much more necessary to do it on a bigger scale in Europe. Yeah. European funded projects where we can develop technology to enable to use EXA and PETA flops systems efficiently. Another part, of course, for our company is to gain knowledge and to sharpen our company profile. And furthermore, to gain experience how to use the system in future so that we can give the best of service to our customers back. And of course, research projects are always part of the way to to find and attract new customers and, of course, our new partners. So we think research projects are a key enabler, a door opener to get things done in this part.
Thank you very much. Next question is for Thomas Blum from Megware. And the question is, what would be your research priorities within the platform?
So the fact that we are going into an energy change over the next years and the challenges for exascale computing in terms of power consumption. So we think the, one of the main priorities should be the energy efficiency and development of water-cooled solutions that can reuse all of the heat what is produced by such a system to increase the energy efficiency for the whole system. So we as a small company working on such projects and have made some efforts in terms of water cooling, and we think this is the right way to go.
Thank you very much. Next question is to IBM Germany representative Michael Maus. The question is, how can IBM, a US company, help creating a European platform on HPC?
Thank you for this question. So first of all, IBM is very committed to Europe. You might know that IBM has more than 5,000 scientists and research and developers in Europe actively working on the IT area. Of course, not everybody is working on HPC. So we're basically acting as a European company here with the same interests. We would like to, of course, we understand that it's important for any kind of HPC vendor to be in very close contact with users. And Europe is very vast and very vibrant in terms of a spectrum of usage and deployment cases. So being part of a team that is actively working in partnerships and corporations with users is very important for IBM as well.
Thank you very much. Next question is for the representative of the platforms, Mr. Zedlok Obansenko, and the question, which is simpler than the family name and the name, is how important is Europe for a Russian HPC company?
Yeah, thank you for the question. And as you know, we have main operation in Russia, of course. And Russia, of course, is the EU, it's not Europe, but the part of it is the Europe. We have very strong collaboration with our European partners, supercomputing center, vendors, institute. We have co-development together, we share ideas, we invest in that money. And for us, of course, interesting, we work in this process, in this platform, to develop the new innovation product for our customer, both sides of the world. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next question is for Dr. Van Lekke from Heidelberger. And the question is Europe a competitor or a partner to US HPC industry?
For sure, it is both. And for sure, it is both, but just has been said, we look at a global market and we are a global company. And in terms of intellectual property, IP, I think it is pretty irrelevant where the headquarter of the company is located. We looking forward to support an ETP, specifically through partnerships with European companies. We're doing a lot of research, specifically part of the exascale research is located in Europe. So the brain power is here, and we have non-disclosure agreement, knowledge sharing agreement with companies that are represented on this panel. And we look forward to enhance that. We also feel that we can contribute to what we think is an essential part of on the way to make Europe more competitive, and that is to make sure that in Europe we have world-class infrastructure, also in terms of knowledge, skills, because a lot of is to do not only to provide systems, but also also the competence to use it in industry and science.
Thank you very much, Frank. And last but not least, the question is to Hugo Falter from Partia Cluster Competence Center. The question is, what are the benefits from an ETP HTC for European HTC software company?
Thank you for the question, Sergei. I think we all on this panel and in this room, we have one thing in common. We are working for the promotion of simulation science. So far, for Partec, for instance, for 11 years in providing cluster software, we were pretty much solo players altogether. We believe it's time now to team up. For us, Prospect was so far since 2008 the platform to do so. And now we are working together to create an ETP on HPC. This will give us several opportunities. Number one, as players within a team on a platform, we can be part in projects. And we believe this is the best way in bringing all our talents, our brains, our services and solutions together to build the machines necessary to support simulation science, the source to get the information and to create the wisdom in the future, to have the tools ready to solve the problems in our societies on this planet, and to create the projects and the solutions we need in our industry. Number two, we believe it's time that on this ETP platform we get the public awareness for the need to invest to enable simulation science. And as a third point for us, it's very important that we have the opportunity as part of this platform to have the ear of the EU Commission to be able to influence the upcoming frameworks. To bring it together, I think if we want to go for XSK, it's a need that we have that platform, that we join together, that we team up, and that in this kind of work together, we build the machines in Europe necessary to get to that point of XSK. So we build us a home where we can work together to achieve the best for HPC in Europe and to strengthen Europe in science and in industry.
Thank you very much, Hugo. So I have final wording. So first of all, I would like to thank the panel and the speakers for the contribution and for staying on the time we have prepared, just for not using much your time on this evening. It is clear and how that Europe requires a coordinated effort in order to become ever more competitive in the area of the HPC. We believe that a technology platform is one of the tools that will help achieve that objective, and we are looking forward to working with all organizations interested in this initiative. Thanks for your participation and thank everybody.